Good morning, everybody. Thank you for your attention with our presentation. Today, I'm happy to be here to talk to you about the KeriFox. I'm Dr. Nguyen Hoàng, come from Gia Đình Hospital, and our team come from Gia Đình Hospital. Our KeriFox is the obesity hypoventilation syndrome combined with the obstructive sleep apnea syndrome and on the asthma patient. And our content is medical histories, clinical examination, test, management, and conclusion. And medical history, a female, a 54-year-old female, come from our hospital with these two blindness. And her batteries, her past history include the childhood asthma and is mild asthma, not severe asthma, and she used ventilator to anesthetize this. And another medication she had lost, and since 1 year, she has suffered from with severe weight gain and worsening snoring associated with repeated sleep apnea. And she had problem with early morning headaches and daytime sleepiness. And she can work so much because she has persistent breathlessness when she working about 10 minutes, 10 meters, and taking shower and changing clothes. And she have frequently used a reliever, and she was hospitalized twice despite she used medication with ICS and LABA. And when we checked for she was an obese woman and with a BMI 32 kilogram per mass square. And she has a shortness, malam body class 4, neck size, so width 40 centimeter. And she had problem with the blood pressure, she had high blood pressure. And we checked her lung cell, it's a clear and mildly reduced. And she has a hepatomegaly and lower extremity edema. And with all information, we thought she has another problem beside the asthma, because with the patient asthma, we don't come from many times hospital, and we think she has another problem. And with the obesity, we think that she has problem with the OSA. And we gave them the stop bank questionnaire and Epworth questionnaire, and her stop bank questionnaire is 7 point, and Epworth questionnaire is 60 point. And we see it's a high risk with OSA. And after that, we check again with the spirometry results, and we see Gensler index is 0.65, and FEV1 and pre and post test is 42 and 44%. Besides the obstruction symptom, we can see the FVC decrease so much. It's not same the asthma patient. And after that, 5 months later, she was performed another spirometry, and we see it's Gensler index decreased, FEV1 decreased so much, and FVC decreased so much, because right now she severe weight gain. And in that time, she was hospitalized because of heart rate, and we see PaCO2 increase so much. She had problem with hypercapnia, and the first two days she come hospital, she had problem with hypercapnia, PaCO2 increase so much, and after that she was treated with the NIV, and PaCO2 decrease. And she is better, she was better. And we think, besides on the asthma, she had problem with OSA and hypercapnia in the daytime. Another problem in this patient, and we check with the cardiovascular investigation, and we see the pulmonary artery pressure increase so much. And in the asthma patient, we don't see that. And on information, we thought besides asthma and OSA, and she has another problem, and we check the sleep test for her. In that time, we use a split night test to check for her. In the early night, we use ALIS-6 to polysomnography to diagnose for her, and after that, we use PAP therapy to titrate for her the pressure to treat. And in the 92 minutes, we can see ASI is 56.2 per hour. It's the severe OSA. And SpO2 less than 90% in 82.9% sleeping time. And lowest SpO2 is 64%. And after that, we use the BiPAP to titrate for her. And we see ASI decreased so much, only 13.2 per hour, and SpO2 less than 90% is in 22.9%. And we have IBAP and EBAP, 22 and 10 centimeter water. We see in the two type of diagnosis time and titration time, we can see ASI is in the diagnosis time 56.2 per hour, and after that, we can see ASI decreased so much, and almost on the diagnosis time is the apnea, and almost its titration time is the hypopnea. And SpO2 decreased so much the saturation, and we can see here, it's a 24.9. And we go to another, and we can see the hypnoram in the diagnosis time and titration time. In the first time, we can see in the 92 minutes, she couldn't go to the REM state. But after that, we used the BAP therapy. She could go to REM state. You can see here. And SpO2 in the diagnosis time, the saturation so much, and in titration time, stable. And we can see the apnea so much and hypopnea, almost hypopnea. And we can see in the Boston of the picture, IBAP and EBAP therapy, we can see the pressure changed so much, but 90% pressure to treat for her is 22 centimeter water with IBAP and 10 centimeter water with EBAP. With this patient, we diagnosed with obesity, hypoventilation syndrome, and obstructive sleep apnea syndrome on the control asthma. And we treat for her asthma, we use ICS and LABA. And OSA and hypoventilation, we use BiPAP, ST, and intensity weight reduction. With this presentation, we have some conclusion. Under diagnosis of the obesity, hypoventilation syndrome, and obstructive sleep apnea syndrome overlap on the patient with asthma leads to serious consequences. And obesity, daytime sleepiness, nighttime snoring, and daytime hypercapnia are suggestive of obesity, hypoventilation syndrome, and obstructive apnea overlap. And clinical examination accompanied with the polysomnography allows early diagnosis and appropriate management. Thank you for your attention.